Hey guys, it's Aaron and Angela Bell here from Smartphone Video Formula, and we just want to give you a little bit of a behind the scenes tour of exactly how we make our videos.
We've seen tons of questions on the Facebook page about people asking what people's setups are and all that sort of stuff. So we're going to show you exactly what cameras we use, what lights we use, the mics we use, the setup we have, and how we do our process from beginning to end.
So here you can see what we use behind the scenes. This is our setup for whenever we're recording videos for our courses, for our ads, for Zoom calls, anything like that, Facebook Lives. We pretty much always just use this little studio space that we've set up. We've got our camera and our mics going right into the computer so that we can get good audio and video quality if we're going to stream it. We've got multiple screens so we can see the screen we're going to share with the audience, but we can also see what they see. So it gives us just lots of screen space to be able to do that. When we're recording an ad or a promo video or one of our course videos that's not live, then we use it just like we are here today, where we just put our Google Doc of the script that we want to use, make the print nice and big, and we just kind of go through it line by line. We'll memorize, whenever we know we're going to be on camera, we'll memorize a line or two, look at the camera, do it, and then get the next line or two. One of the tricks that we use is we film everything when we're doing those course videos. We film them in 4K. What that lets us do is punch in when we're doing the edit. So what that means is if we make a mistake or we want to cover an edit, all we have to do is zoom in on either Angela or myself, and usually you can't even really tell that there was an edit there. That lets us do these videos without a teleprompter, but also lets us cover up our mistakes and our multiple takes. So for our camera, we use a Fujifilm X-T3. We actually have a pair of them that we got for our video production business about a year ago. We really like the image quality that comes out of these cameras. They shoot in 4K internally, right to SD cards. They've got really high bit rate. They're really nice cameras. There's two cables going into this. One is just for auxiliary power, so that makes sure that we can record for long periods of time. And then the second cable is actually an HDMI out. We run this HDMI signal out to a Ninja 5 monitor and recorder, and that's actually where we do our recordings. And it works really well because it does two things. It lets us run the HDMI input from the camera right into this monitor. It lets us push the record button right from here so we don't have to get up and go and do it on the camera every time, which is a real time saver sometimes. And then this monitor also has an HDMI out. So what we're doing here is we're running the 4K signal from the Fuji X-T3 into the Ninja 5, and we're recording on the Ninja 5 in 4K. And even if we're doing a Facebook Live or a Zoom Live or something like that, we also record it on this monitor. It just gives us a higher quality recording than if we just use the Zoom recording. And then the HDMI out is actually a 1080 signal. So we run that into the computer, into the desktop computer. And we just use this little CamLink converter. And what it does is it lets us run that HDMI signal right into our computer. And then our computer recognizes it as a video camera. So instead of using like a webcam or a built-in camera like that for our Zoom calls or our Facebook Lives, we actually now can use our nice Fuji X-T3. We have the color profile in it that we like. We can zoom in exactly the right focal length that we need. We've got it set about F4, which gives us a nice shallow depth of field behind us and gives it a really nice look. And then for audio, we want to make sure that we've got really good quality audio, especially when we're doing our live trainings, because people are expecting to be able to hear exactly what we're saying. And we know if there are any audio issues, it usually causes some real problems. So we want to make sure that we've got really good audio. So we use a pair of these Audio Technica AT2020 mics. They work really well in this kind of setup. We just have one in front of each of us, and we have those running into a Zoom H5 recorder, and we're actually just using it to output the audio signal to both the computer so we can pick up our audio signal. It works as a USB interface, and we're running the audio signal into the Ninja 5 recorder so that we're recording our audio on there plus the computer is getting the audio. Then this setup gives us really nice quality audio. We have a lot of control over it, and it makes sure that our audio in our computer and on our recording is both really high quality. And then we've heard a lot of people talking about their setup, their stage, their background, that kind of thing. And what can you use to get a nice looking backdrop? So we've done two things for ours. The first is we've put up this white distressed looking brick wall. It's just simply a vinyl backdrop, a photography backdrop. We got this one on Amazon for about $60. And it just gives it a nice kind of white brick look. And then the other part we have here is just an Insignia 30-inch monitor that's on a stand. So that sits up in between us. And that's kind of the main piece of our backdrop. One of the things that we teach our students in our smartphone video course is how important light is to getting a good looking video. It doesn't matter what kind of camera you use. Good light will make your image look better than anything else. So if you're recording on your phone, you really want to make sure that you've got good light, but it's important on any camera that you're using. So we love to use these LED lights on light stands. We've got some square light panels that are made by a company called Aperture, and we use those as kind of our accent lights. We've got them on the backdrop to light that up and kind of hide the creases and things like that. And then we've got another one just as a hair light to create a little bit of separation between us and the backdrop. These other LED panels, though, we really like these. They're pretty inexpensive. They were about $150 Canadian per panel. And we bought two because there's two of us on all the time. But if you're just making these videos yourself, this light is going to give you terrific quality of light, much better than you'll get like from a ring light or anything else. And you're going to be able to get it in the US. For US prices, it's going to be about $150 or less, including the light stand. And you got a lot of control over the power. It's adjustable power. You can adjust the color balance. So these lights work really, really well for a low cost. And one of these lights is going to make a massive difference in the quality of any of the videos that you do.
So hopefully that tour has helped you out with your own setup. And if you have any questions about any of the gear that we use, the models, whatever, just reach out and ask us. Or if you have any questions about anything else, we're always here to answer them for you.